This is Warm the Studio, and I'm joined by Sana and Safinaz of Sana and Safinaz, and we're going to talk to them a little bit about their business, how it went from becoming an idea to a business. So Sana, you were going to tell us a little bit about
that. I am Sana, this is Safinaz. I basically just developed from a business. We started this about 20 years ago, and at that time it was just a little idea. We started with two men in a garage, and it's developed into like a major brand. Basically, I think the story here is that we've developed a two-man business, which went into employing many more people and becoming a trendsetter. Basically, we're a brand that's like an aspirational brand. So people sort of follow us. So it's not only just clothes that we do. Our business is very multi-tiered, and we do a lot of other things. But it just grew over 20 years. The first 10 years, I think we spent on just building our infrastructure and letting it grow organically. The last 10 years has been jumping leaps and bounds. In the last 2 years, we've grown at 100% and 100%.
Yeah, that I've seen.
Yeah, so basically, I mean, that's because we've added a category called Lawn, which is a mass market product. It's pretty much Safinaz's idea. So let her elaborate on that.
It's a very well thought out process, actually. I think what a lot of people don't realize is the brand of Lawn with us, with the Sana Safinaz label, is actually a 14-year-old brand. It's a consistent brand that has got a lot of loyalty. Over the years, we've worked with Firdaus, we've worked with Alkaram, we've worked with Lakhani. And what's happened is that over the 14 years, me and Sana have gained a lot of experience. We've got a lot of confidence from doing a brand with someone else. Finally, 2 years ago, we decided that actually we are ready to launch on our own. Now, that platform actually sets an amazingly large platform. Because like I said, you're dealing with a product that every single woman in Pakistan wears. So you really can't go wrong. And Lawn is the most viable product for them because it's the cheapest product. So why not actually give a designer name to a Lawn outfit and actually give a little bit of Sana Safinaz in every woman's wardrobe. So that kind of philosophy works for us because actually everyone does want to wear a designer Lawn. I think we have an added edge on that, and I really believe that is the 20 years of actually being a designer. So what's happening is that in our Lawn, we're bringing in a very strong design element, which I have to say, I don't think the other 40 brands have. Even today, and I can say that with a little bit of confidence, that Sana and I are bringing something very, very different to the Lawn. And the truth is that we're bringing in a designer element. It is not a Lawn for you to wear while you're cooking. We're trying to give you a Lawn to wear for an occasion. Lawn has never been worn for an occasion, for a lunch or a dinner occasion. It's always been relegated to the housewife. And we're trying to make the housewife glamorous. Why shouldn't she look great? Why shouldn't she wear Lawn, which is 100% heat in this country? Why shouldn't she go out and look great? You know, and that's actually what Sana Safinaz give. We give you a valid value-added suit for under 5,000 rupees, and you really can't beat that. Yeah, so that is the story of the success for the Lawn business.
Very quickly, what is your plan for the next 5 years? Are you guys planning to diversify? What are the challenges you're thinking about?
I think basically now the next 5 years is all about we built the brand. Now it's going to be diversifying into different products of the brand. We've got an incredibly loyal following, and that itself, we can go into cosmetics, you can go into perfume, you can go into shoes, you can go into sort of stores. So I mean, there's a lot to be done. I mean, it actually requires tons of capital. So you know, we've grown it one step at a time. So that's where we're going to take it. And also, it requires more than capital. I think that's something that we are less concerned about.
And infrastructure.
No, and infrastructure, Safiya. I think the most important thing is infrastructure. Like we were just discussing, you require a full team of people.
The truth is that a lot of people have money. There's no lack of finances in Pakistan. But what takes a company to the next step forward is actually your vision. Where do you see yourself 20 years from now? And that's exactly what Dalsa was saying. It's not about short-term thinking. It's about long-term thinking and long-term goals. And Sana and I have always thought long-term. Where do you see yourself 10 years from now? And that truly is your imagination. Your finances can come through at any time. You can find the right finance. So there's plenty of money around. But if you don't have a vision, if you don't have an idea or a game plan, you will never go anywhere forward. And it's not necessary that game plan has to be for everybody. Some people like to stay small, and that philosophy works for them. But me and Sana don't want to be that. We want to be the bigger name and the bigger brand.
Just one last question.
Yeah.
You're one of the few women that I've interviewed. Being a woman, whether you're from any kind of class, any kind of background, being a woman and taking that step, going out there and wanting to make your own business and stand on your own two feet, it's tough. What advice would you have for young women?
I think it's a changing world. I think 20 years ago, we faced all the challenges of being women entrepreneurs. I think today, I think we've become sort of like brand ambassadors for women entrepreneurs, because that's what it is. There's two young girls, highly uneducated, come out and come out and just sort of hit a sixer, I mean, that's sort of, it inspires lots of young girls that, listen, you don't have to be an MBA. You know, you have to have passion and you have to have a dream and you have to have a vision about something, like Safi Sahil was saying.
Great. Thank you so much. Thank you. Good luck. Good luck. Thank you.